It is therefore our intention to challenge the Soviet Union not to an arms race, but to a peace race. Let us call a truce to terror. The logical place to begin is a treaty assuring the end of nuclear tests of all kinds in every environment under workable controls. We also proposed a mutual ban on atmospheric testing without inspection or controls in order to save the human race from the poison of radioactive fallout. We regret that that offer has not been accepted. Together we shall save our planet, or together we shall perish in its flames.
The young president had a unique proposal in which the youth of America could actively work for the cause of world peace.
I have today signed an executive order providing for the establishment of a Peace Corps on a temporary pilot basis. I'm also sending to Congress a message proposing authorization of a permanent Peace Corps. This corps will be a pool of trained men and women sent overseas by the United States government or through private institutions and organizations to help foreign countries meet their urgent needs for skilled manpower. It is our hope to have between 500 to 1,000 people in the field by the end of this year. We will send Americans abroad who are qualified to do a job. We will send those abroad who are committed to the concept which motivates the Peace Corps. It will not be easy. None of the men and women will be paid a salary. They will live at the same level as the citizens of the country which they're sent to, doing the same work, eating the same food, speaking the same language. We're going to put particular emphasis on those men and women who have skills in teaching, agriculture, and in health.